The Gemini CLI is a command line tool that uses AI to help you work faster with your code and tools. Let's now learn how to get started with the Google Gemini CLI. First, make sure you have Node.js version 18 or higher installed on your system. Now, let's install Gemini CLI using this command. npm install -g at google/GeminiCLI. Once installed, you can run it using Gemini command. You'll be prompted to choose a color theme. Let's keep it default. Next, sign in using allowed authentication method. If you sign in with your personal Google account, this will grant you up to 60 model requests per minute and 1,000 model requests per day using Gemini. To use a specific AI model or increase your request limits, you can set up an API key using Google AI Studio. I'll sign in using my personal account. And that's it. You are now ready to use the Gemini CLI from your terminal. To see the available commands, just type /help and Gemini will list them for you. The first thing we're going to do is ask Gemini to explain a codebase. Right now, I'm already inside the project directory of my small bug summarizer app. Let's start Gemini and enter our first prompt. Explain this codebase. Okay, Gemini has started analyzing our request. Gemini is now generating a plan to fulfill the request. Task complete. Gemini is ready with a brief overview of the code. Let's check the output. This is a simple web application that uses AI to summarize bug reports. Here's a breakdown. app.py. This is the main application file. It's a streamlit web app. It takes a bug description as input from a user. It then uses the OpenAI GPT-4 API to generate a JSON object containing several summaries of the bug, tailored to different audiences, QA, product management, customer support, along with a user-facing note and a release note. Finally, it displays these summaries on the web page. Next, it provides details about other files from the codebase. For README, it mentioned that the file is empty. So let's ask it to create a README file. And right away, it started working on a README file. Once the content is ready, it requests our approval before making any code changes. Once granted, it updates the empty README file with the new content. Now, let's open the README file in VS Code to review the content. The README looks really good, clear, well-organized, and easy to follow. Now, let's ask Gemini to run this code. Gemini lets us know it's about to run the Streamlit application. This will start a local web server, making the app accessible in the browser. Before proceeding, it asks for our permission. Once we give our permission, the app launches in the browser. Let's test it out and see if it works as Gemini described. I provided a bug description and clicked on Summarize. Here's the output. The app delivers exactly what Gemini described. Bug summaries tailored for different audiences like QA, product management, and customer support, plus a user-facing note and a release note. What we just demonstrated is just one example of how it can be used. It's capable of handling complex tasks by linking multiple commands and services together. Gemini CLI comes with many powerful pre-built tools that can be viewed by running the /tools command. It also supports adding custom tools and commands to tailor it to your requirements. For example, you can extend its capability by adding MCP servers. To set up MCP servers with a Gemini CLI, create a settings.json file inside the Gemini folder of your workspace. Let's connect the GitHub MCP server to unlock more features in Gemini. Here's the code block you need to add to connect with GitHub MCP server. Gemini CLI automatically replaces the GitHub personal access token placeholder in your with the value of the corresponding environment variable. Just make sure you set the GitHub personal access token by exporting it with your own token value. After you've added this code block, restart your terminal, export the GitHub personal access token, and start Gemini. Next, enter the /mcp command. Amazing! The Gemini terminal app is now connected with GitHub MCP server. You can view details for each tool provided by the GitHub MCP server by pressing Ctrl+Tab. Now, let's try this GitHub MCP server by asking some GitHub-related repo question, for example. What are the top 5 open issues in Appium repo? Gemini has begun analyzing our request using tools from the GitHub MCP server. Before accessing the MCP server, it first asks for our permission. Once granted, it retrieves the necessary information from the official Appium repository. Next, let's take it a step further by uploading the contents of the Bug Summarizer app to a new, empty GitHub repository I just created. Here's the prompt I used. Please push the contents from the bug_summarizer folder to my GitHub repository, followed by the repository name. Gemini CLI immediately began analyzing my request and created a plan to achieve the goal. Interestingly, it noticed the .gitignore file was missing, offered to create one, and even made sure to exclude sensitive files like the .env. After I approved each critical step, Gemini CLI successfully pushed my project to GitHub using tools from the GitHub MCP server. Let's check GitHub to confirm the code was actually pushed. And there it is. All the content from my local folder is now in the GitHub repo. No need to remember complex Git commands, just simple English did the job. As you can see, integrating the MCP server has made Gemini an even more powerful tool. You can add more MCP server to Gemini to meet your specific needs. Gemini CLI can combine these tools to create complex workflows. Now it's your turn to give Gemini CLI a try.